Hi darling.
Oh, we started a new video.
Yes, in the last video you were showing me about the your
That's
favorite
only two songs.
Songs
I love them.
Yeah,
so I like.
But I'll just stick to this one. Song, it's good to go to Toto Africa, and that's where the whole song is. Now, why I was wanting to record, or why I'm recording this morning, we woke up and it was very, very frosty. The house was feeling cold, and if I had looked outside, I would have been tempted to go back to bed and cover myself up because it's very frosty. But anyway, I decided that I'm gonna shut that one down because you'll be distracted.
You've closed. You've yes. You've switched. Now you've got rid of me. You've got rid of what I was looking at previous to when you come
Did
and
I?
Hijacked me.
Is it?
Yeah, you've closed everything down.
Oh, I'm
I
so
had pages
sorry.
Open that I was looking
okay.
at. And you've closed
Are you sure?
everything.
I'll
yeah,
show
you've
you
closed
to...
everything down.
Okay,
never mind.
I can put it out.
Never mind, leave it, it's fine.
Yeah. Yeah, it's because you are not paying attention. And I had to close it so that you pay attention. But I'm talking to you.
I was listening. I was watching.
How can you be multitasking? How can you be doing two things?
Multitasking is not just women, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, anyway. What did I say previously then? Well, how did I start the story?
You said that you looked out, if you'd looked outside and seen how frosty it was, you'd have just wanted to go back to bed.
Anyway, comfort zone is very good. And even you now, kind of almost shouting at me because I've closed that window.
Yes.
Are you sure? Can we replay?
Did I shout? No.
I could replay.
I commented.
Yes. Did you comment? Okay. That loud comment you made.
Shouting.
Yeah. That loud comment you made. It's because you like your things to be done the way you want them to be done. Nicely organized, comfortable procedure. Tell me what happens this morning with the lights when you wanted to fix the lights.
With the light?
Yeah, the dimming, the new smart lights.
What happened was,
yeah.
I come down, put the bulbs in.
Yeah.
Of course, they didn't work.
Yeah.
So
they kept flashing and
yeah.
the switch, what was wrong with the switch?
So I got a little bit frustrated and then I realized that we had the wrong switch on the wall.
Yeah.
So I thought, let me have a look in the shed. Yes,
yeah.
I've got a new switch. Come in,
yeah.
change the switch, switch the switch on. They're still not working properly. But after reinstalling the app and reconnecting the bulbs, hey presto, they worked eventually.
Guess what? There's a part that you skipped in the
there
morning.
Was?
Yes. In the morning, you didn't want to do it. You wanted me to do it. So you fixed the light and you told me, darling, you have some work to do to talk smart to the bulbs so that they can work.
Yeah, but that's because you did it last time.
Yes, so you wanted it to be an easier job to be done. And you thought it was easy. But even last time.
But in actual fact, you wouldn't have been able to do that because you wouldn't have been able to change the switch.
There we go. So I'm taking you back. Even last time you were a bit frustrated and you left me
no,
sorting
last
it
time
out.
I was very frustrated.
You were very frustrated.
In fact, the bulb nearly just went in the bin last time. So
okay.
this time was better.
You left me. I managed to do it somehow. And I did give you the instruction. I sent a little video on telling you what you need to do in two steps. Right? Okay, the app is a different one from what you are using today. Right?
Yeah.
The app is different. The other one is something smart and this one is something Colex, right?
Yeah,
like
that's
that.
The make
but this yeah the step is the same, the steps are the same. Now what I'm talking about today is like we like being comfortable, we don't like frustrations, yeah, but in the morning when you wanted me to do it, I wanted you to learn how to do it yourself because I did last time, yeah, but I didn't know how to tell you softly, so I had to kind of encourage you to come to the kitchen with your coffee and you were like, no, I want to drink my coffee, and I said you can drink your coffee with while you're standing here next to me while I wash the pots. And you can bring the app. You can bring the
I like
phone.
To do things when I feel I have time to do them.
There we go. But guess what?
I don't
what?
Like being rushed.
Guess what? Finally, when you got started, you did it.
Yeah, when I get started on something, I keep pushing.
You
but
did it.
I don't like
in
starting
fact,
things.
Including
I don't like
the
starting
switch.
Things when I don't feel I have time to really dedicate or to finish a job. But
we all do. We would like to have the perfect time to do things, but it doesn't always happen. So today, I'm very thankful that some things happen without a proper timing, a proper plan, but they solve the problem. Today, we can use smart bulbs because my darling here kept going. He had to warm his coffee because he forgot he was drinking his coffee. He persevered. He went on step by step. He changed the switch, even when he wasn't so sure where the cables were going. But then after rethinking, he was able to read where the switches were. So I want to encourage you. Most of us want to be in the comfort zones. Most of us would rather not do things that seem so difficult. But life is not easy. The other day, I posted something, a picture from a friend about everything being hard. So you choose your hard. Today, my darling, choose the hard part of fixing the lights. And now we have upgraded the house and we are feeling much better. I'm even now able to do this video here, sitting here with some more bright color in the background and in the foreground. Why? Because he has fixed the light. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to do this. Personally, yeah.
And now when we do Bible study, the room will be brighter.
That's right. That's right. So these bulbs, this solution that you have done today, it will last us a long time. It's not just for today.
Yeah.
Now, because I messed your computer, it seems like it's a hard job to do, to bring back the screen. But I think I can try and bring it up.
You don't need to.
I don't need to. No, are you sure about that?
I can do it in 2 minutes. I do it all the time.
All right. So.
It's not a problem.
What do you think about that topic I'm talking about, of being comfortable? Nothing good comes out of the comfort zone.
Well, let me show you.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
So, it's quite funny, really, because if you look at this, I don't know if you guys
can see. It may come
Can you see you guys?
Yeah.
No, it's back
Great
to front.
Things never come
anyway,
from comfort. It's a reflection.
This is the calendar we've got. So, great things never come from comfort zones.
Yeah.
So, that's prophetic, isn't it?
It's an encouraging way to show that, you know, sometimes people wake up and move on with life and people think other people are having it easy. But no, life is about taking one day at a time, solving problems as they come and keep on moving. And I was also thinking of Jesus. From his conception to his death, his life was never easy. Unfortunately, the motivators, the inspirational speakers tell us that we can have a comfortable life if we have a lot of money. Have you heard those type of preaching or that those type of inspiration that when you have plenty of money?
I don't tend to listen to prosperity preachers.
Yeah.
I don't listen to prosperity preachers.
Yeah. Life is hard.
Jesus never preached prosperity.
Yeah.
Only the prosperity of the kingdom of heaven. So why would I want to listen to prosperity preachers that just want your money?
The word for yesterday was saying, give us our daily bread. So we can be comfortable by giving the needs that we need each day.
These prosperity preachers, especially the American ones,
they
don't just want daily bread. Yeah. They want the bakery as well.
Oh, right.
they want
the bakery.
Yeah.
And once they have the bakery, they bake all the bread. It's not that they eat the bread.
And let me ask you, during these hard times with COVID and this pandemic, how much have they given back to the community, these prosperity preachers that have gathered all this money over these years? I wonder how much has actually been given back. I can't judge, I don't know, but I'm just asking that question.
Anyway, nothing good or nothing great comes from being comfortable. Jesus was never comfortable, so we shouldn't just sit down and think, the lights can switch on without us turning them on and plugging in into the power, into the source, because you had to switch off from the mains to be able to fix the switch. And then we had to uninstall what wasn't good, to reinstall again and to get started. So today, get started. Back to square one. If things are not getting right or if things are not going right, if there are mistakes you've made, don't dwell there. Keep on moving and keep on solving as many problems as you can solve. And the ones that you're not able to solve, delegate them. I delegated my mind to you and you were kind of trying to delegate to me. But guess what? You took the instructions and followed them. And that's why, as Christians, we read the Bible because it gives us a lot of instructions on how to live life on a daily basis.
Step out from your comfort zone.
Yeah.
And you'll achieve things.
So, congratulations for stepping out of the comfort zone today and going on. You could have seen him. You could have seen him. He's smiling now. Did you see the moment when he was frustrated because of
that
me
wasn't
switching
recorded.
Him? It was worse. I mean, how many? 50 times that. This thing is frustrating me now. This thing is frustrating me now. Yeah.
Yeah, it was at that time.
Well done. Anyway, thank you for your time, Mr. Muzungu. I'm posting this on Facebook. Do I have the permission to do
you
so?
You do.
Okay, thank you very much. Bye for now. See you later.